Hi, I'm Misha, Mikhail Starchenko, watercolor artist from Russia, and I introduce you my new course, watercolor course. It's a course about basics of watercolor. So what we do in our course is basic tools, basic techniques and basic tools that we will use in our watercolor paintings. So it's the root of the whole watercolor painting process. Welcome and enjoy my course. I will start with the tools and stuff we need in our course. And the first thing, and one of the most important things, I will tell you, I will show you such slanted surface. I made it from a pizza box. It allows the artwork to be slanted at small degree, no more than 30 degrees from the horizontal. So it's quite critical to the proper to most of the techniques we use in watercolor, for washes, for the proper gravity for our watercolors that we will do in process. And some more about materials now. I use the paper that called Arches. It's a Canson 100% cotton paper. Grams per square meter. So I highly recommend to use very good paper, and this is the best that I can recommend you to use, because in my opinion paper is around 90% of success in your painting against all others materials you use. So I highly recommend again to buy such paper. And about paintings, about paints. I use for last 2 or 3 years I use mostly Mugello Mission Gold line of watercolors. I find them quite intensive and quite good for my purposes. So you can use any brand of your choice. I just suggest again that it would be some professional line of watercolor paints. Would it be Daniel Smith or Winsor Newton or Schmincke or something, you name it, what you are comfortable with, no problem with it. So it's not that critical as a paper. Also, you will need some palette, and there are a lot of different palettes on the market. It could be plastic ones or some non-plastic. This is my last one. I have, you see, it's quite new right now, but this palette is from Mugello, and it it almost helps me to fight from the cat hair in our room. So my paints, in theory, don't have that much hair, and it's sealed, and this is great for me. Also, my paints are always slightly wet with it, not super dry, so I don't have to put a lot of water and wait for it to be alive for my paints. This is water tanks I use. I usually use two tanks at a time. Is it Z, or when I work with detailed images, I just use Z2. One of it is always clean water, and other that I first wash my brushes with. So it's why I prefer to use two water cans when I work. And also quite critical, at least for me, I use only boiled filtered and boiled water to be it as clear as it have to be, without any salts or something that can affect on my paintings. This is also some important stuff for doing big washes or long artworks. This is small mini tanks for the paint with exact transparency. This is an example of my paint. I already have done it for my current artwork, and that paint is always with the same transparency, and the same mix of colors. You can use such stuff. It's my girlfriend, I think, bought it on eBay for this is for some cosmetics stuff or something like that, but it works very well with watercolor. Also, you can have such small mini eggs from Kinder Surprise, we call it in Russia. It works also very well. I don't have now a cup for it, but this works much better. And now about my brushes. I don't really use that much of that Chinese brushes. They are too big for my artworks, even for full sheet. I use them quite rarely. You see, it's already painted that I used it. I prefer to use, and 99% of my artworks, I use synthetic brushes. Even some cheap ones, like this was called in supermarket in for the kids paints, and this is IKEA brush, as well as these two. It's one set for five pieces set with five brushes, synthetic, and they work well. I did a few artworks with that brush alone, almost alone. So you can use any brush that suits you very well. But why I love synthetic brushes, they don't leave hair on my artwork. That for me is quite annoying thing at all. Like this brush, I use it quite rare, Chinese natural brush. But also you will have to some pencils to make your drawing before painting, some tape for taping artwork, and all that stuff. Another type of brushes I use and use it a lot is water brushes. It's a brushes with water tank in it. So you just, it worked like this. This is the brush and here is the water. So what you do really with that brush, you can simply add some water on artwork. And also this brush is very helpful with two brush techniques, and in other cases also what is good about this brush is that you don't have to wash it. You just simply squeeze and clean water from your tank, go away all paint in it, and it's clean. No need for wash it in tank with water. So there are a few different brands. This is Pentel, I think. This is some Japanese, my favorite one, most expensive one, with smallest tip. I found that I really use mostly the smallest tip water brush in my artworks. So this is the smallest one possible, because I have also such kits with that brushes. They have different tips, even flat ones, round ones. But what you really need is only one brush that is as small as possible, because it will help it will do the job in 99% of situations. So that's it. Buy a water brush if you don't have one yet. Also, one thing that I used quite a lot in my work, and even in that course I will use it sometimes, I think it's a masking fluid. Masking fluid is the fluid that becomes rubber when it dries. So we can mask with that fluid some areas and it will dry, and we will have not paint to go under that masking fluid. Then we simply remove it by our finger, and that's it. That's how it works. This is one brand of masking fluid. This is another one, gray one. I just suggest you to have non-white masking fluid, because you will be lost with it on your artworks on white paper. So it have to be some color. This is gray one and this is blue one, blue-green one. Also, you will have to buy some cheap, smallest synthetic brushes as you have. Few of them, at least five. I have much more, just taking here five brushes. For example, this is the same brushes, synthetic brushes that I wash and then apply some soap to it. Soap that you usually wash your hands with. You just slightly add some soap on the tip and leave it to dry. And then these brushes will be cleaned from masking fluid very easily, and you will not have any trouble with it. That's it. Don't forget your paper towel or some paper sheets for drying out some water on your artwork or drying out some brushes, it will be very useful. So let's start our course in next video.